Hi guys, alright, I just want to really quickly put like an announcement out there before I start the video. I just recorded and I forgot to put something in, so I've recently decided to start doing some like base reviews and some more interaction with you guys, because I think that with the channel growing at a decent rate, I think if we do a little bit more, you know, interaction with these subscribers, I think it'd be pretty cool. So I'm planning to do base reviews, and I think there should be pretty decent. So I also would like to see some suggestions. If you guys are like, if you like one series or you don't like one series, just give me some suggestions, tell me what you guys want to see, and I'll happily, you know, try and sort that out. And you know, I'm also, you know, message me if you're a growing channel and you want to do a collaboration or you want to do anything like that, because subscriber interaction is brilliant. I really like it. I always respond to all my comments that I get notifications for. Sometimes I don't come up with notifications, which is really annoying. But also, if you're going to comment and you want to reply, make sure you have your replies on, because sometimes there's a comment and I can't reply to it because the reply button isn't there. So yeah, I'm going to start rambling. Enjoy the video, guys, and I hope you enjoyed it. Hi guys, I'm Rakhtans right here, and today I'm bringing you another episode of War Recaps. And this episode, I'm going to be showing you the war recap on the live war attack I did. And as you can see already, really quickly, it was a close war. It was one star in it for us to win this war. As you see, we did win, but we must give them credit. Now this clan, I think they were Japanese, if I remember, yeah, Japanese, and they did exceptionally well. I mean, the fact that they were so kind of, the base was so underleveled on walls and sometimes the defences, and we outmatched them, they did incredibly well to get 70 stars. I mean, we just managed 71, and 71 against their bases, you know, that was, I wouldn't say it was easy, but you know, we did it. And to be fair to them, it did have very high level heroes, showing their very war clan. I don't know, I'm thinking about it now, I have a theory. So, I know, a theory for me, it's going to be really interesting. So, I'm thinking, the walls being such a low level, maybe because they have such low-level walls and such high-level heroes, they get mashed up with clans that are nowhere near as good as their troops and heroes, so they just go on offense, and then they just kind of ignore defense. That might be kind of something that happens, because with war matchups, the walls are a lot more important than anything else. I think the walls are kind of, they mean the most out of all the kind of factors that go into it, so I don't know. But, I mean, I think everyone got two-starred. I haven't got two-starred, so I don't usually get two-starred. I sometimes do. If it's like a high level player, they're like, I've never been 3-starred. Well, I have once, but that's because I was using a stupid base. So, yeah, these guys, they did use their attacks quite well. Most of their high level players and some of their low level players did really well. So, like, 21 attacks on number 5. So, well done. I'm going to show a few high level attacks, maybe a few low level attacks. So, we've got Gaz here attacking their number 1 player using, I don't know what that is. He's using golems, wizards, and then 6 hog riders. I've never used that attack strategy. I've never seen that attack strategy be used, but you know, it worked for him obviously. So going in, he's got some wizards and a witch in his clan castle. He's got loads of golems and a double jump spell. Loads of his clan castle troops come out, and he doesn't have a lightning, so he's just going to hope for a wizard to take those all out in one shot, which is pretty good. So he's got his freeze spell down. I couldn't think of the name then. So a few things. He's got his hog riders going. Hog riders are actually bossing it. Wow, I didn't realize his hog riders were that good. So yeah, let's pause this and be under 1x speed because in the core now. 43% heroes, the king's activated, but as you see, he holds off on his queen until he knows he can get the 50%. So he'll just wait off on her and activate her either soon or when the queen gets low level on health. So he's got the 50% there, activates queen's ability just to, you know, get the extra percentage points from that, because if he was say on like 45%, he probably would have left the queen for a little bit and then activated her ability. But as he's already 50%, they might as well just activate the ability anyway. So really nicely done there from Gaz. Gaz is always a good attacker, same with like Stitch and all the high level players like that. So number 13, Rose. I haven't personally spoken to Rose, but all the members of Lunar Rise are really nice, and so just, you know, I know everyone personally, not on like a actual personal level, more than like I speak to them in clan chat a bit. But Rose is obviously like either a visiting member or a new member, which is pretty cool. So it's always nice to see new people come into Lunar Rising and do really good attacks. Obviously, you can see it was a 2-star, I believe, unless I got it wrong. So this is a very strange base. It's kind of the distractor design, as you see all the time, but it's a new distractor design. And he's got 3 freeze spells, which is quite interesting. I've never seen 3 freeze spells being used. But if you actually look at, I'm assuming it's at her, if you look at her attack composition, she's using so many witches. What's that, like, maybe 6 or 7? I don't know, we'll check at the end. There's a lot of witches. And it might be due to the single target Inferno Tower, but really nicely executed the attack here, because witches are like very, they're very good if you use them correctly. Like that giant bomb there that you see has gone off could be very dangerous for witches, because witches don't have much health, and obviously their skeletons help them. If it's splash damage, the witches just get annihilated. So really nicely done that you got a 2-star with witches, and obviously nice high level heroes and a few of the backup troops he's got left over. So lots of witches on the left here, a few witches in the core, 55%, 58%, 60%. Really nice attack there. See their queens being activated as he got the 50%, as she got the 50%. Sorry, so she can activate the queen's ability quite early on there. I'm going to go for another attack from Mr. Small. Not another, sorry. I'm going to show Mr. Small's attack, and then I'll show a few lower level attacks. So, nice high level attack here. Another a distractor based design. So, where's he going to go from? Oh, wow, look at that composition. Before we start this, just look at that composition. 14 witches. Seems like that's kind of the attack strategy people are learning to use in these distractor bases. Because, obviously, it's such an open design. There's not many walls on the inside, so I suppose flooding the base with witches and lovely skeletons. Look at that. Christ, that is mental. So there's a lot of skeletons there. Obviously, if there was a giant bomb around here, this would just be an absolute disaster for him. So really nicely done that he was careful about that. Because if there was a giant bomb there, oh, that would suck so much. That would really be very annoying. So, yeah. So his heroes are going in the bottom. And witches are at the top. Very interesting. He split up his troops. And he's... this guy has all archers in his clan castles. That's... I suppose kind of lucky he had witches, because obviously loads of little skeletons can go and take out loads of those clan castle troops. And got some stuff going into the core, lots of little wizards going in. Obviously with multi-targeted inferno towers, see the king goes at the lot. I'm trying to stress the Kelly hero ability thing here, just so people are aware of it. So you see that the witches are there, and it's very risky and very skilled to actually get this kind of attack done, especially with the multi-targeted inferno towers, because even a multi-targeted inferno towers, I think at max level, can only do 5, maybe 8, I don't know, one or the other. These witches, what, there are 14 of them, only spawn, I think, 4, I don't know, I'm really not good at my numbers, I think maybe 6 each, and, yeah, so it's pretty cool. So he's going in, and he's activating the Queen's ability there, getting a bit close here. But at the same time, the Inferno Tower's down, still got loads of witches up. So, really kind of, it was looking sketchy, and then he's brought it back. So he's got level 40 queen, it's already got 50%, so all he needs to do is get the town hall, and he's sorted. So, really nice attack there from Mr. Smalls. The attack strategy that people seem to be using is max witches, which is pretty cool, because I haven't really seen that much. So, I'm going to look at all these 3-stars. Oh my god, Lunar Rising did so well in this war. I mean, look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Get it right. We got 8 3-stars. That's mental. I mean, really nice to have done that, Luna. That's crazy. Let's have a look at the hardest 3-star of them all. I mean, this was a really tough 3-star. I mean, just look at this base. Oh my god, it's such a good base. So he's just going to really have to use all his troops here. Oh wow, that clan castle. Just look at that. And the hero. Oh, this is a tough battle. So he's trying his hardest. Oh, it's getting quite close here. We don't know if he's going to... Oh, he got the 1-star. He's got the 2-star. It's so amazing. So, yeah, I'm taking a pee, guys. This is obviously a base that they accidentally put in the war or something. So, he got... I looked at it. I would have got 2,000 of each loot if I'd attacked that. So, we're going to have a look at the highest 3-star we've got. And that's from Dirty on Koyo, I think his name was. Yeah, Koyo. I mean, the walls are in low level, but I think I may have watched his attack live. Anyway, so this is... This base would be so hard to beat if these little intersection walls weren't here. Your troops are around the outside, but I don't know. The distractor base is kind of like, I suppose, a decent idea. So it's going in with a standard go wipe, it seems. And with obviously the low level walls and the low level defences, it's quite a good attack. So obviously we saw he got 3-star. Let's just see him execute this 3-star. He's in the core. Lots of wizards in the core. Wizards are actually monsters, especially if you have a ray spell on them. And if they're alive for a long time, they just wreck house. They really do. So he's got moderately high level heroes. Queen's ability. I don't know when that was activated, but she wasn't quite low. But he's still good spread of troops. Was able to get a 3-star. So nice 3-star there. And one last raid. I just want to show you a last raid because I feel like we should end something cool. What can we end on? Right, it's the end of the last attack. A little life-saving attack from Mr. Smalls. And so this was Mr. Smalls onto the defender called Squiggly. So I actually attacked his base and I only got 1-star, sadly. But Mr. Smalls goes in with his lovely level 40 heroes. We're all counting on this. We're all begging that he got the 2-star. This is what won us the war. So really nice done here by Mr. Smalls. Again, this is the second attack we've seen from Mr. Smalls in one video. So this kind of shows you guys that he is obviously a very... good player in the clan. He's very, you know, prominent in his war attacks. When I say prominent, I mean like he saved his attack till the end. You know, he's using his attacks very smartly. So when I was watching this, it was just always all over here. I just knew he was going to get 2-star because Queen's in the center there, and she's still got her ability left. And we were all cheering, going mental on the clan chat. It was really good. It was really cool. So I'm really happy about that. So really nice down there by Mr. Smalls. You brought back the war and won us it. So thank you very much. My storages really appreciate that. So anyway, thank you much, guys, for watching. And I'll see you next time.